Hey y'all, yeah, I'm just about to start my day and I gotta pee already, so this is gonna suck. That's another video coming up. I guess I'm gonna be doing videos now throughout this end of the world here. Yeah, these are $1 dollar store reading glasses. I got them last April. I started having a thing where my vision was blurry, and I went and I got an eye test. They said everything was perfectly fine, and the next day it fixed itself. It went away, and up until, you know, last week, now I've got the blurry vision again, so I was fine for like a whole year. But anyway, that's not what this video is about. I have lost a lot of weight driving for Uber. Now, as you know, I started with Lyft last September and was doing like exclusively Lyft for like the first 3 months until they, you know, started, you know, having less and less bonuses, and then once they cut them out, then I switched over to Uber. But anyway, in this time I've, you know, been working long hours, even though I said I only clock, you know, 25 hours on average a week. That's when I'm online actually working on the app. I'm going to put this in a separate video later about the bathroom thing, but I have to take an hour to 2 hours off just to go to the bathroom because there's only one place in the entire city I can go. And like I said, that'll be a future video. But, yeah, so I have to take a lot of time where I sign off the app and go specifically to the one location where I can use a bathroom. And that takes a lot of my time. So the normal schedule I was working was like to start between 3, 4, 5 in the afternoon and work until anywhere from midnight to 4 a.m. depending on demand. If business was still, you know, booming and I was still getting rides, I could be out to 4 a.m. So, yeah, working about 10 to 12 hours a day in total, even if I only log 5-6 hours online with the app, because it takes me forever to get where I need to go to the bathroom every time I need a bathroom break. So, between the long hours and, you know, just being so exhausted, you know, no time or energy to cook anything, I pretty much haven't eaten. I might eat once a day, and that'll be like late at night while I'm working. And even then, I've just completely lost my appetite. I know I'm still big, but I've lost 60 pounds. Yes, 60 pounds in the last 6-7 months that I've been driving. I've pretty much just been on a liquid diet, really. Like, I'll drink my energy drinks, iced tea, soda, you know, whatever during the day. Coffee. So not the healthiest of drinks, but yeah, I'm always got something to drink because for some reason driving makes me thirsty. So I'm like hella thirsty all the time, but I'm not hungry. What I buy for myself is like yogurt and cheese sticks and milk because I just think, you know, protein, calcium, that'll keep up my strength, and that's all I need. Once in a while, my body tells me I need to eat some fruit, so I'll get a little bit of fruit, but I haven't been eating lately. And it's weird. It's taken me a long time to mentally adjust to that because my brain, you know, it's done with this now, but my brain was still thinking of food all the time. Like, what do I want to eat next? What do I want to eat next? Until it finally, you know, made the connect that my stomach is just totally turned off by the idea of food. And yeah. So I went from, yes, eating like a pig to what I say now is I eat like a 4-year-old. I truly do not eat that much. And I've been having to sew up my pants, you know, time and time again. I'll just like pinch the material in like a couple inches and sew it real good so that it stays. And I've done that like 3 times now on my pants and they're still falling off me. Just out of curiosity, I tried the scale that my roommates have like a month ago just to see if I had lost weight because, you know, my pants are falling off me and I thought, you know, didn't I used to be like a little wider when I like saw myself in the full length mirror? And lo and behold, 60 pounds. 60 pounds lost in driving. Yeah, so I'm just about to head out, see if I can make any money today. And I haven't been keeping up with my mail because I have a P.O. box on the far north side. And I'm, you know, staying down here around the Humboldt Park area. And the last time I did get my mail was probably 3-4 weeks ago. Because I truly don't get much mail anyway. So I finally opened my mail yesterday, and the state has been bugging me endlessly for income tax. So the thing is, no matter what, every person living in Illinois owes more tax to the state because it's the greediest state that there is, and they always want more money, and mine is about $450 a year, making $15,000 gross, but after taxes are taken out of my checks, I'm speaking on my previous job, which was a regular W-2 job, I would literally only make $10,000 a year that I actually, you know, took home after taxes. But yet you always owe the state. And so I've got like $300 left, and the letter says that they are going to put a lien on my property. Now, it doesn't mention the car, but I don't know. There's actually no property tax on cars here. The only thing that's considered property is real estate, but I'm still really trying to, get money to get them off my back because the last thing I need to worry about right now is losing my car. As you know, I can't walk very well and I can't get around without my car, so... And yeah, I totally don't even have the chance to work without my car. You know, I can't even apply for any kind of receptionist, you know, front desk jobs like I was doing before. Because all of that's non-essential now. All of the businesses that, you know, need a front desk, you know, administrative assistant, they're all closed. So the only thing people need are grocery stores, you know, Target, Walmart, Walgreens, and all that. They're all hiring. But I've tried to apply with them before. And the thing is, they will not ever allow anybody to have a seat at the register. They're not going to let you sit down on a chair or a stool. You have to stand. You have to be physically able to stand. And Aldi's, you know, Aldi's cashiers... you know, sit in a chair, and I've tried Aldi's before, but their policy is that every single employee also has to unload the trucks and stock the shelves. You can't just be a cashier. So there's absolutely no way any of these places are going to hire somebody with a physical disability that can't stand up all day long. So yeah, I don't have any option to work anything else. Trust me. Believe me, if I could have ever, ever in my life stood up for 8 hours a day, I would have years ago, applied and worked at a Target or a Walmart or whatever, McDonald's even. I don't care. I do not feel above those jobs. I just know I can't stand up all day long. I can't stand for even 5 minutes. By 2 minutes, I'm thinking I'm going to drop dead. I can't do it. So believe me, it's not that I don't want to. I mean, I wish I could. But, again, if you can help, especially that now that I got to get up another... some friends of mine sent me money over Facebook. So what I have left is... $225 is what I need more to pay off the state tax. And just to be safe that they don't come and take my car. Because every day I wake up paranoid thinking my car is going to be gone. So if you can help me out, like I said, please do share the video. Pass it on to your friends. Post the links to the videos that I've been making wherever you want. Okay? Link in the description. It's Venmo at Seth C. Perry. It'll be below so that you can get it correct. And that's it. Peace. Gotta get going.